And welcome back to another Street Fighter Cross Tekken Arcade Mode playthrough. This time I thought, let's get some DLC characters in here. So, let's do Sakura and Blanca. Sakura, her outfits are disappointing. Very, very disappointing because she's got a schoolgirl. Her swap is a schoolgirl. And her alternate is a schoolgirl. So we're going to use her alternate. Blanca, on the other hand, he's got his normal, he has a swap with Harong, and this silly pilot's outfit, in which I want to be the pilot and be Yellow Blanca. Why? Because Yellow Blanca's hilarious looking. And again, what else do I got here for the swap? Maybe we'll use Harong. Maybe Harong? Yeah, we'll use the Harong. We'll keep normal Blanca. Here we go. Right then, story time, so shh.
As Shadaloo and the Mishima Zaibatsu began their battle for the fallen meteorite in the Antarctic, there was only one.
By the way, I like the Dan Hibiki theme playing right now.
That man was Dan Hibiki. He told his friends Sakura and Blanca that the Saikyo arts are going to save the world, and then left on his journey.
Where did Dan go?
Huh? Hasn't Hibiki-san gotten back yet?
Several months have passed since Dan left, and Blanca, worried about his friend, decides to travel to the Antarctic to investigate. Sakura, interested in what secrets the box contains, joins him.
Then we're off to the South Pole! Man, I am so excited. My first vacation somewhere snowy. Woohoo!
Snow makes me cold and soggy.
Cold and soggy. Gross. Anyway, I believe this team is actually the canon team that finds the Pandora's box, as in, if this game is technically considered non-canon, but what these guys, their ending, I want to say, is the canon ending, just because you'll see. You'll see. But yeah, Sakura and Blanca, not much to say about them. They're just Sakura and Blanca.
So, are you ready for the fight?
Alright, Sakura.
All right, Sakura!
Even though I think it should have been Dan and Blanca. Ah! Although Sakura and Blanca makes sense, but I just like Dan more. Because Dan's hilarious and awesome. And I have an entire WWE Day of Reckoning playthrough as a created Dan Hibiki character. Alright. Here we go. Sakura! She's basically her Street Fighter 4 counterpart, complete with everything except for that. I think she... Can she do it? Anyway. Yep, she's her Street Fighter 4 counterpart. Nothing much to say about her. Blanca, I don't know how to use him. He's a charge character. Bastard. Damn it, Steve, how wrong. It's funny. I fought, I believe, Sakura and Blanca first with Steve and Harong, and now I'm fighting them first with Sakura and Blanca. But yeah, not much to say about these two characters. If I can get it, here's Sakura's super. It's one of my favorites in the game. I don't know, I just like the attack! She can charge her Hadouken to only go a certain amount. But yeah, that's Sakura in a nutshell. Blanca will see his super next, if I can get it. One thing I like about this game, too, is that with super motions, besides charging it to get a free super, but super motions, it's just one motion, all three kicks or punches. So yeah. Come on now! Let's get Blanca in here. Blanca is just his usual blanking self. Got the whole ball spin stuff. Oh, damn it. There's a super. Huzzah! And then it's crashing down. It's actually a really cool looking super. And I'm usually not a Blanca fan. Oh, that was a shocking experience, wasn't it, my friend? How dare you. Now I gotta try to get the Pac-Man fight. If you remember my previous video, I missed out on the Mega Man fight. Now I gotta try to get Pac-Man, though. When did Blanca become a monkey? or gorilla, I should say, with the whole Blanca wearing shorts. That's great. Oh, look at him. South Pole, it's pretty cold down there. Wait, down there? Oh yeah, Jimmy-san, you hate the cold, don't you? Jungle is tropical climate. Cold is no good. Yeah, huh? Would it help if we got you a nice sweater? Yeah, sweaters. You always have to be prepared when you go to the South Pole, damn it. Imagine what they were originally dressed in. Blanca with nothing but a, Oh, I can't even remember what he wears. Does he actually wear just shorts? I think he does. And Sakura with a schoolgirl outfit. Julia and Bob. I'll be getting to those guys pretty soon, too. Well, that girl and guy. Okay, Bob.
Okay, Bob.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Leave this to me.
Alright, Bobby. Wait, who start? It's Julia starting off. So that makes no sense. She went to the back, and now she's starting it off. So yeah, take that! And take this! Oh damn, I mistimed it. Here I come! Huh! Huh! I don't think she can do it three times though, unless you charge it. It does make a ground bounce though. Ha! But yes! I forget, can she do it? Yeah, she can do it in the air. Sakura, I kinda like. She's one of my favorite, like, Street Fighter characters, just because she's female Ryu. I could- oh wait, that's when you do the EX version. She kicks him up and goes, bye-bye! Come on! Come on, Bobby! Woohoo! Come on, Jimmy-san! Fun fact with Sakura, she always puts San at the end of every character's name when she tags them in. Like, she'll go, come on, Mega Man San, let's see this. This is actually cool what Blanca does here. His impression of Sonic the Hedgehog.
Let's keep having fun.
And the entire super is actually better than when it actually fully connects, but still.
That was so awesome.
That was so awesome. Indeed it was. Let's go! You just kicked me in the face, you bitch.
Hadouken.
Ha! Ha! Oh! How do you like them apples? Oh, you're not hungry? That's cool. Cause I got more! Hadouken! Yeah, she kinda has a Dan Hibiki style Hadouken there. Hey! There we go. Yes, I can't use Blanca, hence why I haven't used him, like, at all. Cause, he's a charge character, and I've said before, I can't use charge characters, and he's only got, like, three moves. This one, yeah, that was shocking. Tagging, there we go, that's what I wanted. Come here, honey. I'll show you what for. Let's see why they call me the Brazilian Wild Man. Yeah. Okay, I'm starting to get really creepy now. Right. Let me see if I can get this. No, no, don't. Come on. There we go. Let's go. Hey, there we go. Kill him! Kill him before the gauge runs out! There we go.
My perfect body!
My perfect body! Yeah. Now hopefully I get the Pac-Man fight, and hopefully my theory is correct that Street Fighter characters fight Pac-Man, Tekken characters fight Mega Man. Watch, since I missed the Mega Man fight in the last video, it's gonna give me Mega Man, which would be kind of hilarious, which throws my theory completely out the window. But I think Mega Man would be the fourth fight, or I should say Pac-Man. Yeah, it'd be after this fight. Could be wrong, though. Could be very wrong. Oh, Kazuya and Nina. I don't think we've seen this team at all. Dear God, poor Sakura and Blanca have to go against an assassin and an assassin. I think they're actually called the Deadly Assassin or something. I don't know. All I know is they're a cool team.
Follow me.
I like them.
Do we have to take them alive?
It's preferable.
It's preferable, but accidents do happen.
Oh, Kazuya and your English voice. It's okay. It's not terrible. Come on! Shinpukia! Ha! Yeah! Where the hell is my shin... My... There it is. That's what I was looking for. Shinpukia! Haha! Take that! Well then, Kazuya, show us how much you are. You just lost to a little schoolgirl.
Made of awesome.
Wearing some kind of Capcom schoolgirl outfit. Yeah, I don't even know what the hell her ultimate outfit is. Well, I know I'm wearing it, I just don't know what it's supposed to represent. Come here, Nina! Oh. Wanna see why they call me the Brazilian Wild Man? Oh, I gotta stop saying that stupid joke. Come on. Come on, bitch. Oh, yeah, double knees. Double knees to the face. Okay, that's the way it's gonna be. We haven't seen, Sakura's, cross art. My face. Hiya! The little running and uppercut. Laugh, and then Blanca just goes to town. As he screams and brings him down to earth. Fan bloody chastic. Yeah, you tell him, Blanca. Now he's gonna rape her. As he does all of the women he knocks out. Go, go, Bakori Man, you mighty warrior Bakori Man. I know that song. Oh, yes, that's right. A lovely Power Rangers type thing there. We get the Pac-Man fight. Pac-Man, come on, baby. Yeah! Watch it be Mega Man, though. Yeah? It is, okay. Right, so there throws my theory out the window about Tekken characters facing Pac-Man. I'm sorry, Tekken characters facing Mega Man. And so, it's basically, if I fought Mega Man last time, I would fought Pac-Man this now. Now, seeing as I'm fighting Mega Man now, because I missed the Mega Man fight in the last video, I fight Mega Man now, so when I play as a Tekken character, if I get to him, I would fight Pac-Man next. Just beat the hell out of him. He's nothing more than a super old, fat robot. Oh, I was about to say, that was going to be a shocking experience. Look out! Mega Man's a little more annoying to fight than Pac-Man. With his, yeah, that. His ice and his Ryu's stylish moves. Take that. You gotta love that Cutman remix, though. Oh, Mega Man doesn't seem too happy. Kick him in the face! Or just kick me in the face. My face. Yeah, I too can. Hadouken. Aha! Oh, no, no, that doesn't work. No, that just leaves you wide open, so come on now. Aha, you missed me! My face. There you go. That don't work either. Okay. Mega Man's about to feel the wrath of a Brazilian wild man and a... Never mind, I said anything. I'll just drop kick him. So the fight is somewhat completely random. But to get the fight, so far as I said, the things that I've tested that work out is you gotta beat it quick, the first three fights quick. One of the rounds you have to end in a cross assault. And another round, I believe, you have to end in a cross strike. Cross assault, I believe, is the double team super while the... No, that's the cross strike. No, that's the cross art. What am I... Oh, there's so many crosses in this bloody game. You know what? Forget it! Forget it, forget it, forget it. The conditions are still technically unknown. Guy on Abel. The American and the Frenchman. Right? Abel's French, right? I know he's based off of Jean-Claude Van Damme. So he might be Belgian. People are like, how is he based off of Jean-Claude Van Damme? Well, he's got Van Damme's accent. He's got his clothes from a movie. I believe, somewhat reminiscent of a movie. And yeah, he just reminds me of Jean-Claude Van Damme. Bad thing, absolutely not! Oh dear god. Oh, my fist, apparently I can't reach. Because my fists are too small. My delicate little arms. How old is Sakura? She's like 15, right? Yeah. Take that! And that! Yeah, overhead, bitch! Look at that guile. I just kicked you in the throat. Shows you who's boss.
I love fighting. It is made of awesome.
I love fighting. It is made of awesome. Is that what you said? Making no sense! Woohoohoo! That's probably one thing I kind of dislike about Street Fighter is I can't perform Link combos very well. Like that, that's probably the best I can do. But I like the fact that this game gives you an automatic 3-hit combo when you do it like that. And then another one like that. But it leaves you wide open if you don't fully do it to tag in your stop it! Oh, right in the face! I don't think this is worth it, but just to see Blanca come in and do his awesome Roar of the Earth or whatever it's called. That is a really cool super. Really, really cool looking. So yeah, as you can tell with Blanca and Sakura being DLC characters, you can guess that the next team will be DLC characters, and it's going to be Blanca's and Sakura's rival team, which kind of makes little to no sense, but remember what I said about the Bakori Man thing? Remember what Sakura said? Well then, that's going to come into play, so remember that. In fact, I think the rival team is next. It's coming along nicely. Wait a minute. Hey, isn't that? Yep. Now fight your rivals. And I believe I'm going to use a screenshot here for my thumbnail like I do with most of my Street Fighter Cross Tekken thumbnails. The only ones that were actually like fully custom made were the Mega Man and Pac-Man thumbnails, just a fun fact. Everybody else, I was going to make fully awesome custom made thumbnails, but not a lot of the artwork for this game is completely ripped, or it's very hard to edit.
Could you just like maybe wait up a second?
Lars, he's got like this cape with three well, it's like three little capes.
Are you maybe Red Warrior Bakori Man?
Red Warrior Bakori Man.
I knew it. Red Warrior Bakori Man.
Red Warrior Bakori Man.
Oh, and Alicia.
Mighty Transforming Battle Warriors. A popular
Mighty Transforming Battle Warriors.
Red Warrior Bakori Man is the star of the show.
From way to shove the other warriors under the bus. Nobody liked the Red Warrior. That might be my screenshot. But
accept my challenge.
I want to make it that one. Just because I like the Power Rangers poses. Let's get him!
Wow.
Lars, aka, as I said, Goku, Kakashi, all that other great stuff. The only Tekken character to so far appear in a Naruto game. In a strange Naruto outfit. And funny thing is, he's the best character in that game. He's got a gun, too. But it can only be used first. Wow! Wow, girl! Grab me and mid- Oh, are you dancing now? Come here! That's the best I can do. Oh, you didn't see this coming, did ya? Woohoo! Apparently she saw it coming, that's why she backed up a little bit. That was a little anticlimactic, don't you think? Stop it. Stop it. Knees. Give her the knees. Yeah, the knees. The face. Yeah! Rip her throat out. No, no, I wanted to bite her throat out, not throw her that way. Oh well.
I'm hungry!
Blanca, you're on a car back there. I should say that's a truck, but you're on that. And in toy form, nonetheless. Stop it! You know what's a little upsetting, but also, it's alright. So far, Blanca is not in Street Fighter V. That's okay, we got that awesome Brazilian chick with the big Magumbos. Where's my, there we go. Ha! Attack! Well then. There it is, I wanted to do that. And then you can actually combo after that, I believe. The little scream she does. I can't do it, I'm sorry. Yeah! There you go, Lars and Alicia. I got a picture of the Red Warrior Bakori. Wait, the Red Battle Warrior? Never mind. We beat Bakori Man! We are as strong as Bakori Man! And we can only go up from here. We're getting closer to the south. Wait, no. You can't say you're going up when you're heading south. It doesn't make sense. I'm sorry. So you're basically going to say we're going down from here. It's all downhill from here. Jin? Xiao Yu? What are you guys doing here? Oh, that's right. We somehow get onto the same exact sled type vehicle heading to Pandora. Actually, what kind of vehicle is this? Don't know. All I know is this stage is awesome. Regardless of the strangeness of it. Yeah, it's like we get on the same boat as them. Like, it makes no sense with them. It makes sense with Bison and Jury, because they just teleported to there. Jin and Xiao Yu are already there with us. Hovercrafts. Yeah! Take that. Oh, that was a 5-hit combo for me. Oh. I gotta get Xiao and Jin in here soon, as in an arcade mode playthrough. But as I said, I can't use most of the Tekken characters for the life of me, and Xiao Yu is one of them. Actually, is it just pronounced Shout? Oh, nice wall bounce. Too bad I didn't capitalize on it. Come on, show me what you got. I want to answer a question I might get while playing this that I probably have already gotten or will probably get, is why don't you play the game modded? Like the PC version. As much as I would love that, I already bought the game for the PS3. I don't like buying the same game for different systems unless it's like some kind of special occasion I would do. And well, I hear that when you mod the game, it tends to crash with some of these mods that you use. So yeah. That's why I haven't used any mods or whatnot. I gotta do the Sonic the Hedgehog roll. Well, that was shocking, wasn't it, girl? Woohoo! Whoa, grandma! Or wall bounce! Oh, damn it. So yeah, that's why I haven't played the game modded yet. Or probably won't at all. Gotcha! Rolling around at the speed of sound! I believe she's dead. Oh, that's a nice KO shot. That was a cool looking angle.
That was so awesome.
Oh, Sakura, your strange yells and saying how awesome some fights are. Right. Ogre's next. Ogre. Hear random silence during these things. That's because look at that face on Sakura, like, oh my god. And Blanca, whoa, watch out, it's coming. Sorry. From these playthroughs, if you hear like my microphone just randomly cut out, it's because I'm shutting it off when I take a little breather real quick. But hey, just a little fun fact there. Don't think my microphone is just short circuiting out of nowhere. Nope. Wow, this playthrough is actually going a little quicker than most of my playthroughs. Still probably in the 20-minute range. Hopefully not in the half-hour range, though. That's embarrassing when I load up 30-minute videos. Some people load up 10-minute videos and split them up into... Well, they do 30 minutes, split them up into three different parts just to get more views. But me, on the other hand, I'm not about that. It's like, you want to see a full playthrough, you're going to see a full playthrough of an arcade-style game. Yes. Ah! Take that! End that! You bastard. Oh, dear. Aha! Oh, okay, Blanca, you don't want to do your little thing? I'm going to wall bounce you! Kick him! Yeah! Oh, God. That was shocking, wasn't it, my friend? Oh, can I shock you? Electric puns. Get him! Do it again! Oh, I mistimed it. Bite him! Bite him! Bite this damn ancient demon. How is he still alive? Gotta make this magic pixel thing, man. Starting to aggravate me with these playthroughs. I know I should have saved these two for last, as in because of their canon, in my opinion, the canon ending to this game, but I wanted to get some DLC characters early on instead of waiting till the end to do them. Ow! Ow! Come on! Ah! Take that! Ah! Come on! Aw, oh, damn it! I was seeing. Oh, my face! Get him! Oh god! My face! Oh! Damn! Get out of there! A raw tag. You should never raw tag. Luckily for me, this computer controlled opponent is a moron! Told ya! Oh, I got him! That's shocking! God, his health! Why? Stop with the health! Did Blanca just scratch his behind or just tell him to go kiss it? Stop it, damn it! I'ma get ya! Woo-hoo-hoo! Oh, that would have been awesome if I hit him with the last shot. There we go.
What are you?
What are you? In case you didn't hear, Blanca said that. Whew! That was a little fun, as much as I don't like playing as Blanca. But hey! We won. We found Pandora. We got it. We did it, Sakura! Yeah, I'm not gonna be dubbing these scenes anytime soon again. Right! This is Blanca and Sakura's ending, in my opinion, the canon ending to the game of Street Fighter Cross Tekken.
Woo! I am so exhausted. We fought some really tough opponents this time. That was so much fun. I've gotta say, I think we've gotten stronger since last time. Right, Jimmy-san?
I do feel stronger. But whatever happened to Dan?
It's a good question.
Oh, I forgot. You know, it's a bit weird we haven't run into him yet. Man, where the heck did he go? Hibiki-san! Ollie Ollie Oxen Free!
Ha ha ha. Oh, Blanca just angry there. Dear God, Pandora's opening up. What can it be?
It's cold.
Oh my gosh! Hibiki-san!
Are you okay?
Huh? What's going on? Oh, hi guys. Why are you here?
Oh, and they said Dan was dead during the events of this. Nope, he was in Pandora the whole time. Well then. As I said, that's, in my opinion, I believe is a canon ending to this game. Why? It kind of makes sense out of everything compared to the other endings so far. Anyway, I believe this will be Sakurai's epilogue coming up here because we beat it with Sakura in the front.
Thanks to her journey yes. And her efforts.
So then, if you read this, you can read this, because I'm talking over it, but stay tuned for some more Street Fighter Cross Tekken Arcade Mode playthroughs. My name is Klinkeroth, I thank you so much for watching.
Was to grant the wishes of those who found it. As the box vanished after finding Dan, apparently only one wish could be granted. While Sakura was thankful to have Dan back, she couldn't help but wonder if the one wish had been wasted.